this way.
Thank you.
Sorry.
Thank you.
Merci.
This is my side.
It's right over here. It's your boardroom.
Yeah. Right.
Can you come inside, sir? Say what's going on inside.
This side of the table.
Wonderful.
I'll check it.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Hi. Good afternoon. Welcome.
Hi.
I just sat in the desk and put my phone on silent so I don't embarrass myself.
Good point.
Yeah, I'm always telling the rest of. I'm going to sit here, yes. Mona,
yes.
I would like you to sit next to me, please, okay. If you don't mind. Please.
It is a carriage machine. David, how do you want me to show you that?
By making a brief introduction of myself and then introducing you to some of my colleagues.
Could I just give you my business card so you have the name?
And there is coffee and water there.
Oh, lovely. Could I pass to your colleagues? Sorry, my arms are not long enough. and for madame. Yeah, mademoiselle, thank you.
Okay,
please.
Thank you so much.
Pass me this one, this muted. This is Sadaqah today.
American or not is another question.
Bravo.
I'm pleased that you've come here. I have a reasonably long association with Bahrain in one way or another. First of all, I am no relative of Ian Henderson.
Important
point.
Appointed by British.
Yeah.
No, it's always the British fault.
Yeah.
By way of explanation, I first went to Bahrain in 1980.
The same year I arrived there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And it was when Saddam Hussein invaded Iran,
yes.
The beginning of the Iran-Iraq War. August or September? September, you're right. I went originally to write the Financial Times survey for Bahrain, which was in 1980, which actually mentions Mr. Henderson by edification. A map of what is the northern part of Bahrain, which is
our research assistant here in the Middle East Peace Process Program.
Where American citizens aren't allowed to go,
yeah.
And the yellow bits are where Americans are allowed to go,
yeah.
During the day.
Yeah.
That primarily began taking care of the expatriate population in Bahrain, which in fact is the majority of the population. We outnumber the indigenous Bahrainis, as it were. We formed this to help protect expatriates, make sure they were aware of their rights and also their responsibilities, to help them to integrate into society, and to make sure that they were able to form their own social clubs, their own religious affiliations, etc. That we don't have homegrown terrorism, that we reject those who will try and divide the kingdom. To Berlin, to Brussels, to Paris most recently, and we're here in the United States of America in Washington, where we had our event last night, and we go on Sunday to New York, where we'll be holding a similar event, and we are looking forward to working with
Fabulous. I serve myself, my first posting was a young diplomat immediately after independence, 1971, to the UN. At that time, President Bush was permanent representative. Then I came as ambassador in 86 till 90 when Saddam Hussein invaded Kuwait.
Salah al-Jarrah, Khatib Jamir, and also journalist.
You're a journalist?
Yes.
With which newspaper?
Al Ayam.
Okay.
Member of Shura Council.
I work as a presenter on Bahrain Television.
Okay.
Mo'nis Al-Mardi, editor-in-chief of Al-Bilad Daily Newspaper in Bahrain and president of Bahrain Journalists Association by election, not appointing. I'm doing my third terms.
My name is Abdullah Mansour. I'm a retired civil servant. I worked for the government for 42 years. When I retired, I was holding the post of Undersecretary, Ministry of Commerce and Industry.
Si vous pouvez me traduire. Voilà, vous le dites l'imam Chalgoumi. Je suis le président de la conférence des imams de France et je fais beaucoup de travail de rapprochement entre juifs et musulmans. On a fait beaucoup de voyages aussi en Israël, entre Palestiniens, la rencontre avec le président Pérez. On a eu l'honneur de cette délégation qui sont venus à Paris. Ils étaient à Drancy devant le mémorial de la Shoah.
Attendez, s'il vous plaît. Votre nom?
L'imam Chalgoumi, l'imam de Drancy.
Mr. is Imam Chalgoumi, he's imam in Drancy, in the suburb of Paris. He's very famous in France because he worked a lot for the relation between the Muslim society and the French society. And he's very, very famous because it's the first imam who came, for instance, for Charlie Hebdo, when they are Charlie the killing, he was the first to come present the condolence. And he has been with the president of the Imam Conference in France, and he has been in Israel last year, I think.
On a 20 imams with President Peres.
Well, he was invited with 20 imams.
To change, and the view in Washington is that there is movement, but the movement is in the wrong direction. That instead of more democracy, trouble on the streets, Washington is unhappy that it's moving in the right wrong direction. And an example of this is the.
I'm understanding what you're saying.
Well, no, I thought you were agreeing with me. So how do you respond to that?
How do I respond to it? Well, first of all, thank you for the meeting. We're very grateful to be able to have this discussion. And we believe that everything is possible through dialogue. And one of the most important things that can happen through dialogue is that you can correct inaccuracies, especially when people are ill-informed. Not that I'm saying you're ill-informed. But I would like to, first of all, address the fact that we have tensions in Bahrain. I was glad to hear you say that it was not between Sunni and Shia, because that's a fallacy, and I'm glad that you did not highlight that. Perhaps you will later.
I've
but
been there.
You understand.
I've been there four times in the last 5 years or something.
Yeah, and we have several leading members of the Shia community with us today. The situation with Tom Malinowski was an interesting one, and we did have a new law about political societies meeting. They should first do, you know, it should first inform the government, and I understand that this was the problem there. Perhaps as a member of our delegation who has more, more specific, because last year we had our elections, which were overseen and observed by international observers from several communities, including the European Parliament. They were absolutely peaceful, despite activists trying to do otherwise or threatening to do otherwise. They were praised for their openness, for their transparency. And
several months before relations were brought back to an operative level, but the basic problem persists.
Opposition, in inverted commas, Al-Wafaq Party decided to boycott the elections, but despite that, for the safety and security of Bahrain. We, living in Bahrain, have great faith in the security forces, and we had an interesting statement from Admiral Moore, who has just retired as the Admiral of the Fifth Fleet, two or three weeks ago, and he made a powerful statement in the media, evidence that Iran is behind trying to destabilize Bahrain by supplying weapons and taking young people and children, helping Bahrain authorities to catch, you know, these smuggling of the community in Bahrain. And in fact, the week that Admiral Moore made blow the whole island clean out of the water, not my words, those of others, celebrating 800 years of the Magna Carta. You have the United States of America of celebrating, is it 200? Has had 14 years to bring about her democratic process. And quite honestly, I think they've done a laudable job. Bahrain is not the US, it's not the United Kingdom, it's not Germany. And I think, you know, the Democrat
people, but if any of my colleagues want to interrupt and say I've got it wrong, they will. They're like that. Couple of points.
Obviously. But I'm surprised that Washington thinks it's going backwards. I don't agree with that at all. And there are international observers.
Well, part of the problem, and it certainly explains the misperceptions or perceptions, whether it's a miss or not, here, is that there is a spectrum of sheer political demand.
Yeah.
It was a curious occasion because we asked to see the government as well, and the government couldn't put together a group to say it couldn't see us for reasons. Sort of impish type remark. My own view of political sentiment into the unacceptable side. And this isn't a way, from a Washington perspective, isn't a way forward. I mean, most of the people around this side of the table haven't got a nice word to say about Iran. So, you know, you can't, you know, if they smuggle arms, they cause trouble, we believe it, essentially. You don't have to sort of prove it to us.
But
it
is one thing that Washington has not accepted in the past.
9/11 troubles, that sort of faded out, although in your in stuff I picked up last night, you know, a journey of progress, towards progress, whether you've made progress is a matter of issue, and what happens to the structure of power. I was bemused when I went to your exhibition last night. I didn't stay for the conference or for the dinner. The door, the first two stalls, one was for Sheikh Nasser.
Sheikh Khaled bin Hamad and Sheikh activities as well. And the ministries, we had a complete gamut of representation of all different sectors.
To get back into the political process, or is it out of it for the cycle?
Yeah.
It's out of it for the
young man. You know, just stop the violence. And I say, Bahrain needs a credible, hard-working opposition. They will work with the elected government for the betterment of all in society. Every democracy needs that. And they made the choice not to do that, which I think was wrong. But I'll go back to Ambassador Karim. Made legitimate changes and pushed for change in the correct way. And we urged them. My very words to him were, you have a very powerful weapon in your arsenal that you are not of peace. Stop the violence on the streets and sit down, and then the government will be forced, you know, to speak to you on an equal footing, because there is no violence. At the moment there's violence, it's not going to get anywhere. You can't have dialogue and discussions when there's violence. You know, people are being killed, there's Molotov cocktails being thrown in cars and God knows what else. And it affected the whole of society.
Okay, so, but Khalil and Masoud can argue his own case, but let me pretend to argue.
Secretary, not Hogg, Douglas Stern.
Douglas
Stern.
Who was the
anyhow,
secretary.
That started, but the problem is not Ali Salman. His godfather is Isa Qasim. Isa Qasim, he has been in the first, and even I doubt if they have the 50% of the Shia, because most of the Shia concentrated in Manama and Muharraq. They in Qura, in villages, yes, they have their vote in. That's why they wanted Bahrain as one consequence. Anyhow, since His Majesty came into power 15 years ago, he introduced a tremendous reform. by having the national charter, then we have the constitution, and started democracy away from all the democracy. Women have been given the right to vote and the right to be elected. This is the first thing in the Gulf. Even Kuwait at that time, women was not, they didn't have the right to vote. What happened during the so-called Arab Spring? Some people wanted to exploit the situation, especially those who are affiliated to Iran. And they tried to introduce or copy what happened in Tunisia and Egypt and some Arab world. The society in Bahrain is a very objective. Wafaq, they cast a doubt on the first place when this was established, the independent commission by Basyuni, they cast a doubt. Because Bahrain has been a model for years and years since Mesopotamia, an open society, semi-cosmopolitan society. We have people, I born in a place and exporting the revolution to our area. This is the stumbling problem that we are facing. Besides their claims over Bahrain, which we have solved through the United Nations, this is the only case.
Okay, well, bientôt à Paris.
We go now.
Together, yes.
Mm-hmm.
One by one. Okay, when you finish, tell me.
Can we shake hands?
We can shake hands.
We can shake hands.
We can shake hands.
It's a bit less boring that way.
Okay.
Thank you so
much.
Yes.
Okay.
I became fashionable and turned down in the street, in the White House, in the Elysee.
Oh.
I'll shake hands.
I finish?
Produce these great smiles.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.